Hey, hi again. I'm Dave Page. Thanks for stopping by. I have a question. Do you have a favorite one-hit wonder song? Over all the years of hit songs, I mean, there's been a lot of them. I can think of a few right off the top of my head. Okay, I'm thinking now. Elvin Bishop, that great song by Elvin Bishop. What's the matter with your hit? Anyway, this is really stupid. Fooled Around and Fell in Love by Elvin Bishop, another great song. How about that one they used on the Guardians of the Galaxy? Hey, what's the matter? Yeah, some great one-hit wonders. Well, you know what? Star Trek had two one-hit wonders. When it comes to the music scored for the episodes, two episodes each had the distinction of having just the one composer writing the music for it.
Huh?
When it comes to music for Star Trek, there was actually two one-hit wonders. I want to talk about these two episodes that each had just the...
What?
When it comes to the music for Star Trek, when it comes to the music of Star Trek, out of all the episodes scored for music, two of them were one-hit wonders. In his interview with Jeff Bond, Star Trek producer Bob Justman recalled that when they needed a score really fast, they would bring in composers to supplement their regular staff. On one such occasion, they called on a veteran film and TV composer, Joe Mullendore, likely recommended by Gene Kuhn, to score the music for episode 13, The Conscience of the King. Joseph Milton Mullendore, Jr., was born in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, October 21st, 1914, and educated at the Philadelphia Conservatory. He began his career in film and television as an arranger. Well, according to Fandango.com, some music that he wrote and arranged turned up in the 1950s series The Adventures of Superman, and his orchestral march Parade of the Chessmen became the closing theme for the syndicated series Racket Squad. Another Mullendore composition, March of the Rams, was used by NBC as the theme for its Game of the Week TV show during the 1950s. There was so much demand for it from schools that the piece was published in an arrangement for band. Possessing a retiring nature, Joseph Mullendore was a musical figure who was well known among conductors, composers, and arrangers, but little recognized by the public. Regardless, he became a fixture in television music for three decades. Mullendore also scored a handful of feature films, including The Jackie Robinson Story, New York Confidential, and While the City Sleeps. He gained greater visibility in the late 50s and 60s after his friend and colleague Herschel Burke Gilbert was made director of music at Four Star Television, one of the most successful TV production companies of the day. Mullendore's name could be found on the credits of Honey West and Burke's Law, the Rifleman, and Richard Diamond, private detective. Well, during the mid-1960s, he composed music for individual episodes of Lost in Space, Voyage to the Bottom of the Sea, The Big Valley, The Time Tunnel, that was a favorite of ours, and of course, our Star Trek episode, where he created a masterful cue for the opening scene that beautifully captures the sound of the Renaissance era. Let's listen.
Interesting. An Arcturian Macbeth.
Watch him. Watch Macbeth.
But just a bit later in the show, Kirk attends a cocktail party where he meets Lenore Caridian, the young daughter of the theater troupe's leader and star. Of course, what's a cocktail party without music? Check out Mullendore's Muzak-style arrangement of Alexander Courage's Star Trek theme.
Where's Tom?
He went to town. He called. He's on his way back.
Well, this same arrangement would be reused later as a tracked cue in episode 20, Court Martial. But this wasn't his only treatment of Courage's theme. Mr. Mullendore, though he wouldn't go on to score any more episodes, did contribute some library cues for the series, which included this one, used in The City on the Edge of Forever.
I'm going to like this century. Simple, easier to manage. We're not going to have any difficulty explaining.
This has to be one of the most ingenious adaptations of the Courage theme. I mean, for decades, I never even realized what it was until starting to look into it this year. So if you didn't recognize the Courage theme in what you just heard, you're in good company. But maybe this mashup will help. Joe Mullendore left another significant mark on Star Trek with this cue from The Conscience of the King.
Are you like that, Captain?
Okay, this same cue is heard again, tracked in The City on the Edge of Forever, when Kirk and Spock first encounter Edith Keeler.
No. We were being chased by a policeman.
Why?
These clothes. We stole them. We didn't have any money.
Well, after his work on Trek, Joe Mullendore continued to compose for TV. working into the 70s on shows like Land of the Giants, Daniel Boone, Lancer, Mannix, another favorite of mine, and according to IMDb.com, as late as 1976 with one credit on Happy Days, Fonzie Loves Pinky, Part 2. Joseph Mullendore died on June 19, 1990, in Pasadena, California.